Are you wanting to fight with me on your first day back from fishing?
Never. Never, ever.
It sounded like it. If I had turned this on earlier, y'all would have thought so too. I'm glad to have you home.
Why don't you act like it?
Why don't you act like it, big boy? Everybody's telling me how nice you are, and I don't ruin it.
They should know.
Don't ruin it. Hey, guys. Oh, what was the bell? Hey, guys.
Hey, guys. That's the intro for everybody, I think.
The fisherman is back. The fisherman is back.
Hey, guys.
Don't overdo it.
I'm back.
He's back. Don't tell him about my haul from Hobby Lobby and TJ Maxx and Dollar Tree. Is he looking at me weird? Where is my glass cleaner? Okay. It's 1:45. And we're leaving to go get something to eat. Chickadee here didn't make it to church this morning. Had a horrible headache for the last 2 days, right over this right eye, right there. But that's the side that gives me trouble, has for years, so I don't know what it is. But I did watch it live stream, and it was pretty awesome, wasn't it, babe?
It was awesome.
Our preacher, I'm telling you, is on fire. If you watched it today, let me know down below, because some of you are watching it live stream when you can't get to your church, or if you're just not, you know, involved in a church right now. Some of you told me that you're watching it, so let me know if you did. But yeah, this is a 2-day headache, and that's not you, because you've just been home one day. Oh, and he's got heat on and I'm burning up.
It's 53 degrees.
I know it's 53, but I know it is. But how was your fishing experience?
Oh, I had a real good time being away.
I don't blame you. I don't blame you at all. I want to get away too. I don't know. Between keeping the baby 2 days and taking mother everywhere, I was telling them the other day, I don't know where Suzanne time is.
Suzanne times all the time.
You think because you're retired that's the case? That's not the case. Trust me. But how many fish?
Maybe I tried.
Maybe you're going to try it in a couple years, huh?
Oh, you adding some years to it already.
No, I thought that's what you said, too. You said 3. You like that one?
Yeah, it's a little peachy.
It's it's Costa Rica clementine. So it's kind of orangey.
I thought I said peachy.
See, it's a clementine. It does kind of have a peachy taste, though, doesn't it? Tell them how many fish y'all caught. Or how many fish did you catch?
I probably caught in the neighborhood of 50, 60 fish, maybe.
Yourself?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. And this is crappie. And I've had some people tell us that they have crappie. Tell them, so you caught about 50 or 60, so how many did y'all clean? How many did y'all catch altogether in the 3 or 4 days?
Well, some of the guys went down Tuesday afternoon. I went down Wednesday. And then part of them went home Friday. We come home Saturday. Mm-hmm. So, but
it was a mixture of people.
Yeah.
Everybody wasn't there the whole time.
Yeah. So, but, between the three days or so that we fished, we cleaned probably about 150 fish, maybe.
150 fish. 150 fillets. And are we having our fish fry in May?
Well, nobody's told me differently.
Well, we didn't have it last year because everybody was moving.
Right.
And it has gotten so big. It's kind of gotten too big, actually.
Yeah, we made that.
I like to rein it in a little bit. A couple of years ago, last year, or year before last, when we last did it, we had to put up a sign that said, no carry-out plates, please. People were just heaping, because we make everything to go with it. I mean, fish fry, it's not just hush puppies, fries, and fish. We do slaw, we do potato salad, we do baked beans, we do corn casserole, mac and cheese, we do it all.
Chicken fingers for the non-fish eaters.
And alligator.
Alligator.
Have some people that come up from Louisiana. And they bring gator. I don't eat the gator. Do you usually eat the gator?
I always eat
the gator. Do you? Does it taste like chicken like everybody else says everything else tastes like chicken?
I guess you could say that, but it tastes like gator.
Has a distinct taste?
I think so.
Yeah. And they know how to cook it. I mean, they're Cajuns and they know how to cook it, don't they?
Absolutely.
So, but it's gotten where it's gotten away from just family, and it's gotten where it's really big, and we want to get it back down to where we at least know the people that are coming. What do you think the biggest crowd we've ever had there is?
I think if you count the kids and all, probably 200.
Yeah, I think so too. But John was able, they had a men's feast at church a few weekends ago to where they just fix all kind
wild game
feast. And John was able to cook crappie there at that. So that was exciting that he got to do that at church. There was about 200 men at that, wasn't there?
Yeah. Actually, my brothers cooked.
Oh, yeah.
And I prepped.
Okay. So. How did y'all have at the wild game feast?
We had crappie and some gator, and we had bison. We had...
Who brought the bison?
I'm not sure where they got it from. We had elk. We had quail, we had deer meat, about every way that you could think of.
That was new. I don't think we've had one of those at our church. If we have, it's been new.
It was our first.
It was first, okay.
They've had them in different areas.
Yeah, I know, like at Ashley's church, they've had them. You've been to that one before, haven't you?
No, I went to be in State Night.
Oh, State Night. Well, it was like 200 men there. It was just great. Our new pastors are just bringing in new and exciting things for all of us to do, and just got such a vision for the community like I've never seen before. So it's a real exciting time at our church, and we have prayed many years for this. But I didn't get to go. Last Sunday was so good. So many of y'all have watched the video that John took for me while I sang in the choir, the Pain Taker video. And so many of you have told me that you've been singing it all week long. I have too. I have played that video. Brenda Dodd, that sings that, she's been at church. I've been there 37 years, and she's been there longer than that. And she is a tremendous vocalist. I mean, she had the opportunity when she was young to sing professionally, and she turned it down. And she's always sang for the Lord. And one of the most dedicated women of God, prayer warrior, cute. Me and her cannot sit together. We used to do very large Easter productions, and we did them for years, and they were called Easter Glory, and then His Glory, I think we changed it. But she and I used to sit together in the choir, because we would have the complete scenes made, and would be in full biblical costumes, and me and her would get in trouble all the time, because if you put the two of us together, we're going to be laughing and talking and cutting up. So I love me some Brenda Sue Dodd. And she doesn't have Facebook, she doesn't have any social media, she doesn't get on the computer. I'm like, how do you live? She said, quite nicely, I guess she does. But I didn't get to go this morning. This headache, I just took something just a few minutes ago, but I told John I have not just been out at all. So I took a shower. I watched the service live stream, and it was so good. I really want to go back and listen to it again, because that's how good it was. And write and take some notes, because I always take a lot of notes. And we're so excited about Tuesday night for our Bible study, because our pastor's wife, she's our co-pastor, she is coming to speak to my young ladies' Bible study. And there is no telling how many will show up for it. There will be young ladies that show up for it that don't come to my Bible study. And that's A-okay, because we want them to come and for her to minister to them. And I have a friend named Jolie Leach. And I believe you can look on Facebook. Her name is, I think she's got set up her business now is Jolie Boley. It's J-O-L-E-Y-B-O-L-E-Y. I think it's what it is. But she makes the most awesome cakes. And so a few weeks ago, she saw where I had bought cupcakes and stuff for them when we did a little Valentine social. And she wrote me and she said, can I make you a cake one night for your Bible study? And I said, you absolutely can. March the 14th. Yeah, she's made all of our kids' birthday cakes and just so much stuff. So she's making us a really special cake, which we will make sure and advertise and put her link below for that. In case you are local, and I know we do have a lot of local people that watch, but I've got to get with my leaders and we're going to have some few other refreshments, but the refreshments are not even the thing Tuesday night. I am just praying for the power of God to fall on those young ladies and for lives to be changed. I can't express to you how passionate Jamie Massey is, our pastor's wife. She and we call them our co-pastors because she has a speaking ministry of her own. She does many, 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 many women retreats. She's gone lots of weekends on Fridays and Saturdays speaking, but she's just amazing. And she grew up through some hard things for God to use her. And so I am so excited about Tuesday night. I've got cleaning to get done, but the next 2 days, my number one goal, I'm cleaning out my den and where I've thrown stuff in the closet. John came in there last night and he said, where did all this stuff come from? Well, it's just been shoved in there. So I'm just doing some spring cleaning. But my main goal the next 2 days is, while I'm doing stuff in the house, and is to be in a spirit of prayer for God to use her in an amazing way. To use her
big old turkey down there.
Big turkey?
Big old gobbler.
A gobbler?
Yep.
Man, I missed that. So this headache has got to flee in the name of Jesus. Because this is not the week to be dealing with it. I told John yesterday, I had a pain so severe over my right eye that if I had not just had a CAT scan, I would have been a little scared because it was so severe. But I had a CAT scan just a few weeks ago because I was diagnosed with a little bone tumor years ago, and I have to have it checked ever so often. But they called back, and I told you this, they called back and said that they didn't think it was a bone tumor after all these years, that they thought it was just a little thickening of the bone. So praise the Lord for that. But so I just did have a CAT, but I just had a severe, I've had a severe headache, and I got up early, tried to get ready and go, and just could not do it. So anyway, just wanted to know if you got any fishing stories you want to tell? I just got so far away from fishing. Ooh, what's a big old deer? Did you see it, Dad?
Oh, well, we don't look for dead stuff.
Roadkill. Hey, tell them what else you see besides fish down there. Because they're in the... Is it swampy?
Oh, yeah.
Tell them what else you see.
Well, me and my cousin Jeff, we always have a story to tell. John and Jeff.
John and Jeff?
Yeah. We go by Crappie Cousins.
Crappie Cousins.
That's our title, our handle, whatever. But we have seen some pretty awesome stuff in the past down there. We saw a squirrel kill a snake. We've seen wild boars.
Yeah, those things scare me.
Oh, yeah.
You should be scared, right?
Oh, you should be, yeah.
Do they have tusks?
Yes.
Oh, Jesus.
And we saw two rattlesnakes weekend four last. This week we saw a big cottonmouth.
Oh my gosh.
Then we also saw a red fox squirrel with a black face, and I think it had white cheeks.
So was the water moccasin laying up on a big limb? Wasn't that? Y'all, I'm
terrified.
I am terrified of snakes.
And alligators as long as this car. Well, maybe not 18 foot, but we see Probably the longest gator we've seen is probably 12 to 14 feet.
Have you ever seen one bigger than the one that you and I saw?
That is about the big. That one you and I saw was one of the biggest.
How many years ago was that when I went with you? About 5 or 6 years ago? Mm-hmm. I went with him. I don't fish, but we went down, and y'all, there was an alligator laying up on the bank. Now, we're in a boat with a motor, but not a big boat, just a fishing boat. And I had my big camera with my zoom lens. Oh my gosh, he was massive, massive. And about the time he turned, he stayed up there for a good while, and then he turned that head, and he started getting in the water. Me and John hightailed it out of there.
She wouldn't let me turn the motor off.
No! Heck no! That thing could come up and bump your boat, and you would be supper. You know he could turn that boat over.
Well, if he's so desired.
Yeah, oh my gosh. And so the cottonmouth was huge, too. And rattlesnakes.
Rattlesnakes.
In trees.
Over the water.
No.
Yes. It's not very unusual, but it was.
Rattlesnakes in trees?
Over the water.
And so, like, did y'all go under them?
No, but I went over and I shook the trees and made them move. My cousin likes it. Watch it run up that limb. I don't really think it was going to run up the limb, but who knows. But we have a theory behind it all because why the snakes were laying up in the tree so much, the rattlesnakes, is because the wild pigs will eat snakes.
Oh.
So we kind of feel like there might be something to that, reason why they're lying out over the limbs.
I cannot tell you what shivers are going over my body right now. It is not the Holy Ghost.
Deer, we saw deer out there 2-3 weeks ago, too. See everything.
Do y'all see why I pray for him while he's gone?
We had
I pray every night when I lay down.
Two armadillos come up in our camp that was chasing each other at
night.
Are
you serious?
Oh yeah, and we put a spotlight on them, and I mean they came within 15 foot and they were, I ain't never seen armadillos run so fast, but they even
didn't know they
over,
could run
they
fast.
Can. You, they were, one was chasing the other.
Oh my gosh. So y'all were out in the wild blue yonder. Y'all were out in the out in the wild area. I mean, this is a camp. This is a camp on the Alabama River. Mm-hmm. Alabama
it's
River.
It's actually a federal park.
It's a federal park, yeah. But buddy, you better know what you're doing when you go there.
And watch where you step.
And watch where you step.
And tote a big gun.
And tote a big gun. Have y'all ever seen any rattlesnakes or cottonmouths up in the park?
The park ranger, or not the park ranger, but the park attendant, last year, I didn't see it, but Mickey and Ronnie and them did. He didn't even realize it. He cut one with a lawnmower in the park. We've never seen a snake in the park where they keep it clean. But he ran over one, and Mickey said that thing was 4 or 5 foot long and that big around.
Oh, my Lord.
He said,
I cannot tell y'all. A snake could almost give me a heart attack. There's no way I could kill one. I could run. Or either have a heart attack there, I don't know, but just they're from straight from the pits of hell. But anyway.
Oh, there's eagles down there too.
Oh.
We don't have an eagle cam like that little baby hatching eagle.
I know.
But there's.
Did you see the eagle?
Didn't see it this trip, but my sister, I think, got video of it.
Oh, that's
fall.
Right. Yeah. Well, anyway, this video is already running way over. But we're just out enjoying this pretty sunshine, going to get something to eat. And then going back home, I'm glad to have this man back home. But I did better this time. He said, oh, you didn't miss me. Now, I just think I was so busy by having the baby 2 days in a row that by having him 2 days in a row, I just collapsed at night. I think that's what it was. Because you have to hold him a lot and soothe him a lot. But I did some good video of him talking and everything for them, so they got to see him. But the other day when we were riding to Fultondale to eat, this woman said, y'all sure do have to drive a long way to go eat. we go everywhere. We like just to get out. Oh, John, there's a huge new house up there.
Oh, I see.
We we just get out and go rambling, but it's nothing for us to drive 20 minutes to go get something to eat, because you got to, we live in rural Alabama.
This is not New York.
This is not New York. No, you don't walk down the block and get something good to eat. You got to get in your car and go.
No subways, no public transportation.
No. We drive everywhere we go, and but we're driving almost an hour to a place just because we're getting out and enjoying the sunshine, and it's just a place that we don't go a lot, in a little town that we like to go to. But anyway, we're going to get off of here and go get something to eat, and it's been great talking to y'all today. I wanted John to tell you about some of the fish. Oh, I've got that one picture. Have you got some pictures on your phone?
I do.
I'll insert a few pictures of their fish that they caught here at the very end. So
Now, my brother weighed one that he had gotten before I got there, and it weighed 2 pound 2 ounces, and it was a crappie. And he caught another large one, and they left the day before we did, and he called me and he said, we left some crappie for y'all to clean, and he said, I got a great old big one in there. Well, I caught 3 big as his, bigger than his big one. We had 6 crappie that I estimate, the 6 crappie total, I would say probably 15 pounds, and that's just crazy.
Really? People, yeah, because crappie's not that big. Yeah,
most people ain't going to believe it. They're going to think it's a bill, but I mean,
I did make pictures. Okay,
I'll
put some in here. Okay, well, it's been great talking to y'all. Talk to you later. Tell them bye, fishermen.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Little gator sitting over there. Little 4 or 5 footer. This is our lab daddies we took out of there. Gonna show you how long these fish are. You can't really tell.
1 foot ruler, and they're still 3 to 4 inches longer than it.
This is what we got. Let me just show the audience what we do. We catch them like this. You look right here. You can just see it's as long as my arm is, from my finger there to my elbow. Down to my elbow. And I mean, not only do we catch one, look at here. We just slide this
we
down.
Multiple.
We just got them everywhere.
Help Bam slipped out
there. Oh, Bam caught this one. We was comparing it to Bam's fish. Here's Bam's fish, and here's my fish. It speaks for itself. I hit that stop button.